Understanding the M2 Money Supply. A Guide for Investors. The concept of money supply is fundamental to understanding the mechanics of the financial system and its impact on the broader economy. For investors, comprehending different measures of money supply can be instrumental in making informed decisions about their investments. In this video, we will delve into the M2 money supply, its components, why it matters, and how it can impact the investment landscape. What is M2 money supply? M2 money supply is a measure of the money supply that includes a broader range of financial assets than the basic M1 measure. It is considered a more encompassing measure of the economy's medium of exchange and store of value. Components of M2 money supply. M1 money supply. This includes the most liquid forms of money, such as currency in circulation, coins and paper money, demand deposits, checking accounts, other checkable deposits, NOW accounts, ATS accounts, traveler's checks, near money. These are financial assets that can be quickly converted into cash or are near cash assets, including savings accounts. These accounts are interest-bearing deposits that generally offer a higher interest rate than checking accounts but have limitations on withdrawals. A surge in savings can indicate consumer caution or anticipation of future spending. Time deposits. Also known as certificates of deposit, CDs, these are fixed-term deposits offered by banks with a specific maturity date. A rise in time deposits can mean that consumers are looking for safe, short-term investment avenues. Money market mutual funds. These are funds that invest in short-term debt securities, such as treasury bills and commercial paper. They're seen as safe assets, and an increase in their holdings can indicate a flight to safety. Why is M2 money supply important? Economic indicator. An increase in M2 can indicate a potential growth in economic activity. When there's more money in circulation, consumers and businesses tend to spend more, which can stimulate economic growth. Monetary policy. Central banks, like the Federal Reserve in the US, monitor M2 when making decisions about monetary policy. Adjusting the money supply is one of the tools central banks use to influence interest rates, inflation, and overall economic growth. Inflation indicator. Rapid growth in M2 can sometimes signal impending inflation. When there's too much money chasing too few goods, prices can rise. Investor sentiment. A rapidly growing M2 can also indicate that investors are moving their funds from riskier assets like stocks to more liquid assets. Conversely, a decreasing M2 might indicate that investors are becoming more confident and are willing to invest in riskier assets. Examples. Economic growth. Suppose there's a significant increase in the M2 money supply because of an increase in savings accounts and time deposits. This can indicate that consumers are saving more, which can be a precursor to increased spending in the future. For investors, this might be a positive sign for consumer discretionary stocks. Inflation. Let's say the M2 money supply grows rapidly over a short period because of a surge in currency in circulation and demand deposits. This can be a sign of potential inflation on the horizon. For investors, this might be an indication to consider assets that traditionally act as a hedge against inflation, like gold or real estate. Flight to safety. Imagine a scenario where there's a sudden increase in money market mutual funds, leading to an uptick in the M2 money supply. This could mean that investors are seeking safe havens due to economic uncertainty. In such cases, defensive stocks or government bonds might become more appealing. Implications for different asset classes. Equities. A rapidly growing M2 might suggest that there's more money available for investment, which could drive up stock prices. However, if the growth in M2 is perceived as a sign of impending inflation, it might deter investment in equities. Bonds. If M2 growth leads to expectations of higher inflation, bond yields might rise to compensate investors for the decreased purchasing power of future interest payments. Commodities. Assets like gold often act as a hedge against inflation. Thus, a surge in M2 might drive increased investment in commodities. Historical context of M2 money supply. Historically, shifts in the M2 money supply have been precursors to major economic events. Financial crisis of 2007 to 2008. Before the financial crisis, there was a moderate increase in the M2 money supply. However, in response to the crisis, central banks around the world adopted quantitative easing policies, leading to a significant expansion in money supply metrics, including M2. Economic landscape of the late 1970s and early 1980s. The U.S. was engulfed in a period of stagflation throughout the 1970s, marked by the troubling trio of high inflation, lackluster economic growth, and increasing unemployment. This challenging phase was shaped by a mix of external shocks, notably the oil crises, and internal economic dynamics. As the decade neared its end, Paul Volcker took the reins as the chairman of the Federal Reserve in 1979. Faced with the pressing issue of rampant inflation, Volcker's Federal Reserve embarked on a bold course, significantly hiking the federal funds rate. This monetary tightening ushered in a recession in the early 1980s but was pivotal in reining in the inflationary spiral. It's essential to note that while there were shifts in the M2 money supply during these years, the stagflation's roots were deep and diverse, making it reductive to ascribe the period's challenges solely to M2 fluctuations. International comparisons. Understanding how the M2 money supply behaves in different countries can provide insights into global economic trends. China. In recent decades, China has seen rapid growth in its M2 money supply, mirroring its economic expansion. However, this has also raised concerns about potential asset bubbles and the overall health of its banking system. Eurozone. The European Central Bank, ECB, responsible for monetary policy in the Eurozone, tracks the M2 money supply to make decisions about interest rates and other policy measures. The ECB's management of the M2 has been instrumental in addressing economic challenges, such as the sovereign debt crisis. The M2 money supply serves as a pivotal indicator of an economy's vitality, offering a synthesis of its most liquid assets and those that can be readily converted to cash. Historically, fluctuations in the M2 supply have often signaled broader economic trends, from impending recessions to growth periods. Furthermore, by comparing M2 trends across nations, investors can glean insights into global economic trajectories and potential investment opportunities or pitfalls. However, it's essential to understand that while M2 provides valuable information, it's but one piece of the vast economic puzzle. The interplay between M1 components and near money offers a nuanced view of consumer and business behaviors, which can guide investment decisions. For investors, it's not just about tracking a singular metric but interpreting it in the broader context of economic indicators, global events, and market sentiments. By mastering the intricacies of the M2 money supply and its components, investors can be better equipped to navigate the complexities of the financial world, making informed decisions that align with both short-term objectives and long-term financial goals. If you enjoy our videos, we'd appreciate it if you could like, subscribe, or share. Thank you.